Okay, now let's review this mechanical modeling problem for the following system. So the input is a torque, output is a displacement. So input in terms of torque, T, output is the displacement. We want to know the relationship between the input torque and output displacement in differential equations. So let's do the free body diagrams. So let's isolate the systems here. So in this case, the drawing, you will have a torque T and the resistance from the dampers will be opposite directions. That's BT theta dot. And at this point, you will resistance from the spring, which is KT theta. Also, you have a reaction force from the rack. So the drum or the pinion rotate clockwise. So you will have a resistance force from the rack. That's F, let's say FG. And that give you a free body diagram. Of course, if you want to consider the supporting force, you should have X and Y passing through the center to support this whole thing, and that's equal to kinetic diagram, which is I theta, which is Im plus Ip theta double dot. And make sure the direction is correct. You see the direction of theta is this right here. So the direction of theta is clockwise. Clockwise right here. Okay, once we set the free body diagram and kinetic diagram, we can set it up. The differential equation, which is T. Let's get a thicker pen. T minus resistant torque BT theta dot minus KT theta. Also the torque due to the force from the rack, which is FG times distance R. Equal to, let me put it, M plus Ip theta double dot. That's one. Second one, on the rack, this is a action force, reaction force. In other words, the force due to the pinion to the rack, its opposite directions, FG. And if the rack moving to the left, I have resistance, BKX and BX dot. Moving to the right, so that give you kinetic diagrams and R. Let's move one two step, which is M R X double dot. So Newton's second law of summation F, Fg minus Kx minus Bx dot equal to m Rx double dot. And again, we can check the directions. Make sure you get the free body diagram and kinetic diagram correct. So we defined x here, which is in to the right, left as positive. So force as positive here, and force to the left as positive. So one last equation is needed, is the relationship between x and theta. So in this case, tangential velocity x should be equal to r theta, x dot equal to r theta dot, r should be capital, and x double dot equal to r theta. So with these three equations, and we can get overall output-input relationship.